forces beyond your control can take away everything you possess except for one thing: the freedom to choose how we'll respond to those challenges. Now, I'll point out the obvious here. This is probably the only guy that can come out on stage wearing sunglasses and pull it off, right? And I share this with you because I want you to know that this is a prosthetic. So I headed off to the University of California, Berkeley to study international diplomacy and to be a diplomat. Except that all changed on February 6th of my freshman year. And there was two agents inside the subway booth, and they were both up against the wall screaming because a guy had broken into the subway booth and he was attacking them. So I said, "Hey, you know, relax, calm down." And he charged at me and he ran at me, and about four or five blows later, my world went black. I had very significant short-term memory loss, spatial orientation deficit, other deficits like reading retention deficits, neuro-ocular motor dysfunction means my eyes stop working together, fatigue, and most devastating was this complete and total loss of purpose and meaning and who I was. So how do you create a path to authenticity, which has been my challenge since deciding to wear my sunglasses? It's about taking your source of insecurity and transforming it into a source of empowerment. Instead of doing what we traditionally think of, which is, does this person have the background and experience to fit nicely into this little position as an optician, or this person as an administrator, or whatever? Instead, what this research challenges you to do is think instead of your practice team like a puzzle, and there is a piece missing. And all of those puzzle pieces are different, but the differences in those pieces fit together and help you create a clear, operating, and effective team. You're already a high-performing team, but what they wanted to see is how could they measure high-performing teams and get them even better? So they wanted to study cognitive diversity. All of this is so that you can create a team that can deal with adversity and change and tackling any problem that comes your way. You guys are a huge organization, a huge company. You're always growing and changing. They're always rolling out new initiatives on you, right? New ways of doing things and looking at things. The reality is, in big companies, that's what happens. You want teams that gravitate to that, that take it as an opportunity. If your eyes are the window to the soul, but that window is obstructed, what does that do for your relationships? For a long time, I hid my sunglasses in my bag, and I sustained serious migraines and headaches as a result of not wearing my sunglasses. But at a certain point, I reflected back on what drove me, the drive to create some sort of an impact someday. And it was through that drive that I decided to change the way I looked at my sunglasses, to wear my sunglasses, and to switch from my sunglasses being a source of embarrassment to a source of empowerment. And as you look at ways to push your own personal boundaries and create ideas that are so bright and a future that is so bright, my hope is that at some point we will all have to wear our sunglasses. Thank you very much.